The idea for the Stat Carnival started at the Tipton Pork Festival when I was there with my kids and they were riding the rides and there were carnival games and I was just looking at people playing them thinking, this could be fun to actually have my students do this. So at the end of the year when we had time after the AP exam, and we had about 2 weeks that year, it was trying to figure out what do we do. So I gave students the option of either building a carnival game or doing a research project that involved running an experiment. We only had maybe 45 to 50 kids that actually came down and played the games. And after that year, we ended up, I made it just a mandatory project because everybody seemed to enjoy it so well. It did a great job of applying what we learned in class to an actual activity they could do. So I made it mandatory. So the second year we had probably 30 games. Last year we had 35 games. This year we were at 42 games. So I bet we probably had about 300 kids probably come to the carnival. For the students, I think it helps them make that connection with the probability and statistics with how it can be used in the real world. Now, I don't think any kids are in the business of building carnival games in the real world, but seeing how what we're doing does connect with probability and chance gives them a little bit perspective on how we can apply with what we're doing in the classroom.
When we learned stuff in stats, a lot of the stuff had to do with what we had to do in our project. For instance, we had to take test results, analyze them, find an average, compare that average, and see how much we'd have to actually price our game to end up making a certain amount of money, which we didn't need to do, but we wanted to make it realistic. And we ended up finding a test average per person that was very close to what we found when we actually tested it at the stats fair.
For the school, I think it's nice for students to see that what's occurring in their classrooms is applicable. Even if they're not in AP statistics, to be able to see a group of 180, 190 kids running a carnival using stuff they learned in class, it may make them think a little more about my classes, that even though I'm not in AP stats, my classes probably have some relevance to the real world as well.
The carnival this year was really fun. I've never done it before. So my favorite part was just getting to take one idea and another idea, bring it together full circle, and get to see the final outcome and see how great my project was compared to other people's.
I think my favorite part is seeing the different games that kids come up with and how creative they are, and then watching everyone seem to like different games. Because I certainly have my favorites as the kids come in and they deliver them to class that day, because return from break, they bring their games in, I play them, I look at their statistical model, and I have my own personal opinions, but once the kids come and play on the day of the carnival, it's interesting to see how some love this game, others like a different game, so the different variety is probably my favorite part, seeing how creative the kids are and everything they come up with. I think my biggest goal is just for it to continue at the same success rate, probably. I think it's really enjoyable. The kids like it, who build the games and run the games. The students I have in AP Stats enjoy that part of it. And the kids who come to play the games seem to really enjoy it. So I'm kind of happy with where it is right now, honestly.